I'm Bill Boggs. What do you think about this? A woman, 8.5 months pregnant, hit by a drunk driver. The fetus inside her, 8.5 months old, is killed. Is that driver guilty of murder? Is he guilty of something called feticide? Well, yesterday we started. Today is part two of a face-off on that subject. Let's get to the face-off. Our guests include, on the left, Bill Baird, director of the Bill Baird Institute, and on the right, Olivia Gans, the Aborted Women's Outreach Project. Olivia, when you refer to something as feticide, what are you talking about? What's feticide?
Feticide is a legal term similar to infanticide or patricide, referring to a member of one's family, for instance, in patricide, which would be
yes.
the father. And infanticide regards the age of the child, and feticide also is a term regarding the age of the individual who dies.
All right, now to review yesterday's, or the day before yesterday's, actually the Minnesota decision. Bill Baird, will you quickly review for our audience what they decided about this 8.5-month-old fetus?
They basically decided that the fetus was not a person based on the common law that you're not a person till you're born. Simple as that.
All right. This is our face-off. You say it's feticide. Try to convince Mr. Baird why.
Well, the simple logic here is that something, someone has died. There was no argument in the court, I believe, that there was a death involved. A death of an organism had happened. Feticide is to try to prove feticide allows us to believe that there was an individual's life taken. Fetus, of course, referring to the term little one. Fetus only means little one or young one. And certainly that child who in a few short weeks would have been held in the mother's arms, just in about 2.5 weeks or possibly a little bit more, would have been held in that woman's arms, she is now grieving for. There was probably a nursery set up. There was probably a layette bought. That is a couple that are grieving right now.
Well,
for
there's no question about the grief, but Bill, philosophically, will you address to her why you believe this was not a murder, why this was not a human being?
Well, first of all, Bill, I deal with reality. Most of us know watching this broadcast that when we're born, we're given a birth certificate. No one is given a conception certificate. When you talk about infanticide, you're talking about an infant that is classified as a person. You talk about patricide, you're talking about a man who is a person. In over 200 years, you've never seen a state law pass that an embryo or a fetus is indeed a person. So to suggest that this man should be charged with the crime of murder is ludicrous, because reverse that. Suppose a woman had gone through childbirth,
mm-hmm.
and now she died. Do you then charge the child, quote unquote, with involuntary manslaughter because the child died, the mother died as a direct result of childbirth? Or if the woman should be a heroin addict and takes heroin and it goes through the placental barrier and the baby's born addicted, does the baby then now, quote, sue the mother? Or if the woman is poorly, has poor nutrition habits and the child is somehow misformed or in some manner, do you then sue the parent?
Interestingly enough, Bill, there are a number of states that are producing wrongful birth, wrongful life suits that would do exactly that, where the child would be able to sue the parent for some deformity that child suffered because of something that the parents had done wrong. I don't personally know whether that's always the right or wrong course to take, but it is a legal option that many states are encouraging because of that very possibility.
But we're still talking about state law. Can you tell this audience, any state, not this year, not last year, over 200 years, that an embryo or a fetus is a person by law?
Interestingly enough, there are a number of states where in almost all 50 states, with the exception of about three, a child unborn is able to inherit the father's property. Should that child
Hold on. If
in
it's
the process,
unborn,
in utero,
what? If it's unborn, how can it inherit? It's got to be born, does it not?
In 50 states, in almost 50
Wait,
states,
does
no,
it have to
no.
be born?
No, it does not have to be born in almost 50 states.
Oh, so this is wonderful. A fetus within a woman's body
is capable
can go
of being
into
named,
a mother's
can be
house.
Named in a will
That's
to inherit property. So
now,
therefore,
if it's born dead, what does it inherit?
If it's born dead, like anyone else who is named in a will who is dead, there is no inheritance.
So therefore, then it's not a person, is it?
If it's dead, it is no longer a living person.
The 14th
but
Amendment,
a legal
said,
amendment
wait,
says that the legally...
Let's talk
is
about
a
law. The 14th Amendment says what?
The 14th Amendment says
that a person
we are
is one
persons.
Who is born. Born, right? Does it say from the 6th month or the 6th week? Or does it say from birth? Is that not true?
I am going to have to say that if the almost 50 states of this union believe that a child unborn is legally acceptable to be named in a will for inheritance, then those states have made up their mind that legally they can apply humanity to that child.
I think the audience saw that you couldn't grasp what I said.
No.
We'll try another point. Name me any state that a birth certificate is not issued to a live birth.
There are some states I know of that do issue for second trimester and third trimester abortions a death certificate. Right. So that implies there was life, wasn't there?
Listen to the implication.
You asked if there was a state
any state that has a birth certificate at 8 months, 6 months, 4 months, 3 months, 2 months.
Or I will be honest and say that I am not a lawyer, and there I have to admit that I don't know every single state's legal action on such a point. However, I do know that it is commonly understood in a great number of our states that a child support law can be enforced on a man for an unborn child as well as a child
if
he may have
now living. If a woman falls down a flight of stairs,
yes.
Okay, miscarries, do you charge her with murder if she deliberately miscarried?
No.
Why not?
Because the accident of falling down a staircase is
so,
an accident.
No, I didn't say that.
He said deliberate.
I'm sorry.
Deliberate
well,
miscarriage. Listen,
creates
a miscarriage.
Listen carefully, right. She deliberately fell down the flight of stairs, now miscarries. Do you indict the mother with charge of murder?
Well, personally, I don't believe that that would be a reasonable thing to do. No.
Okay, now the car crash. The fellow didn't know the woman was pregnant, crashed into the car, the fetus dies. Now you want to charge him with murder. Aren't you rather consistent?
Well, now, hang on now. We have a situation that's arisen in our country where we have to take rather stringent measures with reckless drivers, drunk drivers, etc.
You're going to charge
Bill,
with murder now?
Bill, wait a minute. Hear me out. Since we have to have a situation in our country where because people are reckless behind the wheel of their car and a car can be used as a dangerous weapon, we have had to take such measures into hand. And occasionally we have had to say that someone can be charged for murder because of reckless driving
behavior.
As
a means of behavior control in automobiles,
well,
that's crazy.
Well, we all have to wear seatbelts in the state of New York, don't we?
What's that got to do with the charge of murder?
It has to do with a society's right to protect the individuals in that society.
Okay, so now the woman falls down the flight of stairs, and now she's a heroin addict who deliberately took these drugs. Okay, now what do you do with her?
You're creating a rather bizarre situation.
Is it bizarre? Heroin addicts don't fall down the flight of stairs?
This is what I want to do. Anyway, we're going to take a break now and get some phone calls. And our phone number, by the way, 570-1199. We want you to call with your questions and comments, particularly good, hard questions on this. When we come back, we will continue right after this. Welcome back. It's our face-off part two in the second segment of it. Our number 570-1199. If you've just joined us, what we're facing off is the Minnesota decision that said an 8.5-month-old fetus that was carried, obviously in the mother, in an automobile accident, actually a drunk driver, struck the mother. The mother survived. The 8.5-month-old fetus did not survive. The decision was that the fetus was not a human being. Therefore, the drunk driver could not be charged with murder. Let's get into that specific decision. What really upset you about this Minnesota decision when you heard it earlier this week?
Because I'm a woman who has been through the abortion experience and who now accepts that the child I lost was a human being, I really am upset at the fact that our country will not accept that all human beings, despite their place of residence, despite their size, age, or anything else, are important and valuable.
All right, and Bill, what you're basically saying is as long as that fetus is in the womb, it's not a human being. I mean,
obviously,
it's a terrible tragedy, an 8.5-month old.
Sad, but that's the way life sometimes happens to all of us. Because reduce it from 8 months, suppose it was 6 weeks or 8 weeks. Mm-hmm. Then you would then charge the driver also with murder. If that's true, then what do you do with the woman listening who has an IUD in her body for birth control? Do you charge her for murdering a person?
Well, that actually is a good point, Olivia. Why don't you respond to this? How far along do you take it? I mean, if a drunk driver hit a woman who was
6 weeks
four
pregnant.
Weeks... Five,
well,
6 weeks?
Where does
it become different for you?
Since I believe that life begins at conception, then I do believe that we may get to a point in our country today where if that's a human being, a living human being that we all accept as one of our community, then it would possibly have to be murder, feticide, throughout all 9 months. Now, there's a difference in a woman using birth control because there's not necessarily any conception there.
An
there's
IUD
no other
for
human
misconception.
Being.
An IUD for misconception, does it not?
But we don't know
and
whether she is...
And it prevents the fertilized egg from attaching.
No.
It is a legitimate means. Therefore, you would charge that woman with murder.
Not
as you would. Why don't you turn yourself in for murder since you admit you've had an abortion?
You know, Bill, I'll tell you right now,
why
on public television...
Why haven't you turned yourself in?
Because it isn't a murder. It is not a crime at
but
this
in
point
your
in time
mind,
because
it's murder.
Court. And I would gladly spend time behind bars for the loss of my child's life. Here and now on public television,
why don't
television,
you volunteer
I say,
and do that?
When and if our country makes the crime of taking a human being's life in utero, exactly what it is, a crime. And if it were to ever come down to a point where I would ask, be asked to spend time behind bars for my child's life, Bill, I would do it in a minute. And you could personally take me to the jail.
And there are millions, I would never be that crazy. There are millions of women who feel differently than you. Millions of women who think that a fetus is a fetus, no more than an acorn is an oak tree, a chicken egg is a chicken, therefore a fetus is not a person. We had an election recently.
We have to establish that,
Congressional districts are based on a number of people who live in a community. Do pregnant women now count as two people?
Many times in our states, we do have separate rights for pregnant citizens because there is a secondary citizen
involved.
Tell me,
any state, I dare you to tell this audience, any state that a pregnant woman counts as two people.
She counts as two people under child support laws in New Jersey.
Vote. We're talking about election. I said congressional. Listen to my words.
Congressional
districts are based on the number of people who live in a community.
Yes.
Does a pregnant woman then count as two people and have one vote?
No, any more than a 16-year-old can vote until that 16-year-old turns 18.
But a 16-year-old is called a person. Name me any state where that pregnant woman counts as two people. Or if that pregnant woman wants to go to Europe, you need a passport for each person.
Bill, obviously she does count for two people in some states of our union because we have states where child support laws indicate that a mother who is carrying a child within her can demand child support not only for the 2 and 3-year-old she has living in her house, but the child within her.
Child support.
For the child. It is true. In New Jersey, they can claim certain degrees of child support for
now,
the child, for food,
one of your
for
big
shelter,
champions, one of your big champions is Senator Jesse Helms,
yes.
Right? He's got the Helms Amendment, who would ban all abortions to save a woman's life. He knows he's a chief lobbyist for the tobacco industry. We know if you smoke a lot that you miscarry. You know that, right?
Yes, sometimes.
Would you indict Senator Jesse Helms as being co-conspirator in murder for being the chief lobbyist for the tobacco industry that causes miscarriages?
Well, I'll tell you. I'll answer you.
Yeah.
I believe that while an individual may be clear on one point that I can agree with him in, you know what, Bill? There are many, many areas where I might necessarily challenge this.
Would you charge a woman who smokes with the charge of murder if she miscarries?
No.
Oh, but you would charge the car driver who didn't know the woman was pregnant.
Does it matter whether he knew she was driving with her 6-month-old infant in the car beside her or that she was pregnant? He did not know that she had a 6-month-old infant in the car beside her.
Well, he was drunk to begin with. I want to just interrupt for a second. We've got some phone calls.
Okay.
This is going very well. Interesting points on both sides. Bill Boggs with you here at midday. Hello.
Hello, Bill. My name is Clarice from New York.
Yes. What do you think? What's your question?
Oh, boy. I think a lot here.
Good. I'm glad we're reaching you.
Bill is really making me angry for the beginning because the fact that he is a man, so he would not know if a fetus is a baby because he has not felt a baby within him. I've had an abortion at a time of 5 months, and that baby, I will tell you, it was a baby. I did not know when I had a salient abortion that I would see a full baby, hands, toes, finger in the mouth, the whole thing. It was a baby, believe me.
Obviously.
Okay,
wait a minute, Bill. Yeah. Now, when my mother was 9 months pregnant, she was hit by a car with me in her stomach. When I was born, when I laid down, when my feet went up, when they put my feet down, my hip would go up. I had a deformity. Now, I believe that the man that hit my mother when she was carrying me should have been charged with whatever happened to me, whatever the disease was, and the bills that she incurred when she was hit by the car.
Let's take that second point, because I think that second point is one that hasn't been addressed. Not the murder, Bill, but the deformity of the fetus. Fetus comes to term, fetus is born, drunk driver caused the fetus to have some problem. Address that to our viewer, and then we'll get to the first point.
Okay, well, you hit it on the target. Your key word was when it's born. There's your word, so that's where the argument settled. But let me go back to
Would you support her claim that drunk driver?
Yeah, I think that anyone going to a court and seek any claim, but not to deprive someone of their freedom or indeed the death penalty by charging them and convicting them for murder. But let me finish, please.
She doesn't like the fact that you...
Like the first part she said was very offensive to me. She said, I'm a male. As a male, what does he know since he doesn't carry a fetus? If that rationale prevails, then let's have a woman you and I debated on your show with, Dr. Mildred Jefferson, who has no children, sterile women who have no children, Senator Helms, who has no children, President Reagan, who cannot have any children of his own directly, that all these people should not be allowed to speak on abortion issue because they can't have children. That's a ludicrous argument.
You know, Bill, that's fascinating. For many, many years, the men of this country have been saying, well, it's a woman's right, and women have been saying that only women can speak on this issue because they are the ones who will carry the child. The men cannot speak. And now to hear Bill Baird say that men have a right to speak, I think is wonderful.
I've said it for 22 years.
Quick point, because the phones are next.
That woman mentioned that, and Bill's talking about, the damage is done to a fetus. Within 15 states of our union, there are laws that say that if any harm, any negligible harm is done to the child in utero, and it can be disclosed that it was in utero, that person can be held liable for the damage done to the child.
Let's go back to the phones. If you're listening, you're on. Bill Boggs with you. Hello.
Hi, Bill.
Hi.
Okay, first of all, I'd like to say that I, in fact, like what Bill Baird had said, fell down one time being almost 7 months pregnant and did, in fact, lose my child.
But did you do that on purpose? He was talking about it. All right. Go ahead.
I did go to court. I did not feel that I should, in fact, sue anybody with murder. I did get compensation for what had happened.
I mean, it was an accident in a public place or something like that, a workplace?
Yeah, in a supermarket.
Okay.
And I don't feel that this man should be charged with the murder either. I think... is a child, this makes me very upset because of when I went
All right, just let's have Olivia ask you one question and then get your reaction. We'll go to another call. What do you say to this woman who basically disagrees with you on this?
Well, I believe that we do have a great deal of room for leverage within these kind of court cases. There would be circumstances where perhaps not murder, but damages would be the thing to go for. So I think that it's not a cut and dry
thing. But it was negligent on their part.
Pardon?
Why I fell. It was negligent on the supermarket's
So perhaps the thing there would have been a situation of damages, and you would have had every right to do as you did and to get that money. So frankly, what I would say to everybody out there is that these are new court cases.
But it's the same type of thing. I lost my child because of this. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
The man, like they said, the drunken driver, it wasn't his fault. He didn't know that the woman was
pregnant. Well, it was his fault. He was drunk on the road, and that's illegal.
He didn't know the woman was pregnant.
Correct.
Okay,
But it is true, isn't it, that he would be just as responsible for the death of the child if the child had been 6 months old in an infant seater beside him.
Okay, let's say this. If the baby was born, however, how many, almost 8 months old, would the baby have been able to live out of the woman's...
Yes. By 6 months, by 5 months, at the age of 4 months, with 1 pound of weight, babies
Bill
are born
disagrees, obviously. Thank you very
Little baby was born in Florida this year, just a couple of months ago. The child did not even weigh a full pound. Her name is Kenya Keys, and she lives in Florida, and she's doing beautifully.
All right, go ahead, Bill.
I don't know what fairy tales you live under, dear lady, but let me tell you that you do not live at 5 months. You do not live at 4 months. You do not live... Okay. Well, my bottom line is, go back to the fact where the caller had, the charge would have been murder. Mm-hmm. Charges murder against this man. If this man were convicted, he could be given life imprisonment, or indeed might argue the death penalty, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth concept.
If they had it in that state, possibly.
Okay. I think that's rather ludicrous to suggest that if you're arguing 8 months, go back to what we said at 8 weeks. You can't turn around and say because you happen to believe it's a person that you're going to impose that on all these people. For over 200 years, a fetus has never been declared by state law to be a person.
And now we're at that point, aren't we? Just
let
as
me
a
interrupt.
Black person
I want to interrupt because we're back at a similar point. Let's get one more phone call at least in. Hi, this is Bill Boggs with you.
Hi,
hello.
Good morning, Bill. I'd like to adjust my question to Ms. Gans.
Go right ahead. Olivia Gans is ready for your question. What's your name, by the way?
Bob. From
Go
Bob.
Ahead, Bob.
Bob Uden. Suppose a woman was 2 months pregnant and she had no idea she was pregnant, what then would be the attitude of the courts towards this man?
Well, if she had no idea that she was pregnant.
But subsequently, at the hospital, after the accident,
she miscarried.
It was discovered that she was pregnant. Would he still be charged with murder?
Well, now see, that's what we have to get to a point in our country where we decide whether or not we accept that the child within her is a human being. If we believe that it is a human being, and the Minnesota case, did us actually a favor because it's challenging that very issue. We do, as a nation, have to come to a point where we either decide that a human being is a human being or it's not a human being.
There's something else
if it was a human being at 2 months, if it was a human being, it should be that.
You can go on and on and on with life begins, but I have an 11-month-old child, and I don't know anyone who has held a fetus and enjoyed the attitude of being a parent of a fetus. You're not a parent of a fetus.
You're a parent of a child.
You don't
hold it, do you? Because it's in utero. Ask a number of women you know if it isn't the joy of their life when they first feel that child kick within them. There is a joy to knowing that child within
you. That's an emotion. Emotions aren't born. Children are born.
All right. Bob, thank you
very
much.
Fetus means little one.
Go ahead, Bill.
Can I respond, please? Well, first of all, in some cases, it's a joy. To other women, it's a nightmare. That's why you have women who aborted themselves with coat hangers and knitting needles. We saw a woman die with a knitting needle impaled in her uterus. So for not all women, is it a joy. But the incredible thing in thinking what she's saying, if it really is a person, okay, are we 9 months old when we're born?
In China, you are. In the United States of America.
By the way, they changed that hundreds of years ago.
Oh, but it's still an interesting thing that they
In the United States of America, you are not 9 months old when you're born, okay?
Maybe we should be.
Well, then what are we going to do with Social Security laws and other things that decide how old we are to reach a certain level in life?
Well, we might have to come to a point where we make some big decisions, wouldn't we?
Well, let's make the big decision. Let women be free to make that judgment call for themselves. Simple as that. Let women be free.
I made that decision.
Okay, that's you. Mm-hmm. Majority of American women, poll after poll, disagree, which is why you see 1.5 million women get abortions every year. They don't think they're killing a person.
That's not why there are 1.5 million abortions every year. There are 1.5 million abortions every year because women in this country are not being given the proper support they need. They feel they have no choice.
Olivia, they feel they don't have the money.
They feel they don't have the job skills and no one cares. They feel they don't have it.
Olivia, with due respect to you, I see thousands of pregnant women a year.
Yes.
Thousands that I counsel. Mm-hmm. Your track record could never match mine. Tell this audience how many pregnant women you see per year.
How many pregnant women I see per year?
I say on record, I counsel thousands of pregnant women a year at my 3 abortion facilities.
Okay.
Now, you name me how many you do.
You've been doing it a lot longer than I have. I've only been in this business for 3 years.
I'm saying per year. Tell this audience how many pregnant women you counsel that you really know how they feel.
That I personally counsel,
yeah,
not
you
that
personally.
I refer,
no, that,
that
you
I personally counsel.
Counsel.
Last
I
year,
personally.
I counseled 35 women personally.
Okay. Then I'll let the audience at home sit back. I'll take the several thousand per year that I counsel, who I sit with,
and they tell me,
Bill Baird, I would rather take my life than go through this pregnancy.
Bill, you know,
I don't consider it a person.
You know,
so let women make that judgment.
Bill, I work with a nationally organized group of women who've been through it. You know that. You know that while there are many women who feel at that moment in time that they could not possibly cope with what is about to happen to them, the subsequent 7 months of pregnancy, because by the time they make the decision to abort, you know most of them are into the second and third month.
You know that's not true. 93% of all abortions are done in the first 12 weeks.
Do you disagree with that? That's the third
93%.
Month,
93%. The first 12 weeks is the first trimester we're talking about. Okay?
That's the third month.
Okay, would you like to know?
12 weeks is
wait
three
a
months.
Of that, 92% are done between the 7th and 8th week. Did you not know that?
Yes, I did know that.
Okay, so that's not the third month.
We covered that territory yesterday. I want to get back to the phones, okay?
Yes.
Bill Baird with you on Midday. Hello.
Yes. I wanted to ask Ms. Gans if she could be more specific on her point that the fetus is a human person.
All right.
Her point about the being able to be named in a will certainly does not stand up when you could even name a cat in a will. That doesn't make them a human being.
This is true. There is perhaps some indication that that is not the best qualification. But then I think we have to look at some of the most fascinating things that are happening in our country, which happen to be in the medical profession. Instruments that are involved in things like fetoscopy, ultrasound, real-time ultrasound pictures, the whole possibility of prenatal surgery. A doctor does not operate on a patient that is dead. A doctor operates only on that which is living.
Right.
We all acknowledge that which a woman carries is a living organism.
Okay, let's give our caller a chance for a rebuttal here.
Sure.
What, by the way, we didn't get your name. What is it, ma'am?
Maria.
Yes, Maria. You want to have a rebuttal to Olivia there? Is she
well, yes.
I do
not deny that the organism which is within the woman's womb is living, but it is not a human being.
How do we describe it? It is a fetus. What is the chromosomal makeup of that which she carries? That baby that she carries has only a human genetic makeup. It does not have the genetic makeup of a chicken or a dog or a cow.
Maria, it must be human. I thank you. Let's have Bill Baird jump in to probably support your argument here. Go ahead, Bill.
Well, the genetic part obviously isn't what really makes you a person or not, because you have a genetic code in your teeth and your bones. That doesn't make you a person, okay?
Right.
So don't use the argument of genetic code.
But it is a human genetic origin, isn't it?
But that's not what you're arguing. You're arguing it is a person. Let's go back to her point, though. Is it not true, in previous debates with me, you said that that fertilized egg is a person?
Yes, because it's no longer the two separate cells.
So if that is a person, since we know that 24% of all pregnant women miscarry before the 12th week, all these embryos should be buried as a person, all of them should be added to the population statistics as a person, every miscarriage should be investigated. If it was deliberate, then you charge the woman with murder as a person.
No, we don't charge her with murder.
Wait a moment. If a woman deliberately miscarries, you won't charge her with murder?
No.
But yet you're just a person.
Because you have to realize, Bill, that over the years and years and years of this country's lifetime, There has never been a woman who was put behind bars for a miscarriage or an abortion.
Oh,
never.
How dead wrong you are.
That is not dead wrong.
Watch this, watch this.
There
University
have been abortionists
Kentucky,
who have been charged.
University
but not
of Kentucky,
women.
Watch this. Mary Ann Downey was arrested for aborting herself.
Is she behind bars?
And was, yes, she was put behind bars.
She's not held behind bars. She was let out of that courtroom because the court was right. She had been put through a torturous ordeal, and she should
Bill
not
and
be
Olivia,
put
and she was acquitted by temporary
insanity. Excuse me, I hate to interrupt, okay. What I think is very high level of discussion. You've debated before.
Yes.
You'll be
back
to debate again. Also want to thank our viewers for good calls. We have to take a break right now.
Alan Zweibel, original Saturday Night Live writer and Thurber Prize-winning author of The Other Shulman, says, "The Adventures of Spike the Wonder Dog is so smart, witty, and inventive that I had to keep reminding myself that I didn't write it."